Hi everyone, welcome to the classes on mechanics of solids. So in the previous class we were discussing the topic principle of superposition, and we have already discussed two problems in connection with that, and we will do two more problems in connection with the same topic, principle of superposition, and after that we will go for the next topic. So this question, a steel bar ABCD of radian cross section is subject to an axial force of 60 axial force as shown in figure. Find the value of P necessary for the equilibrium. Here they have given first force as 60 kN and second force as P. They haven't given the value, and third force as 120 kN and fourth force as 96 kN. So I already mentioned for the system is in equilibrium, the net force acting on the system should be zero. So the leftward force should be equal to the rightward force. Okay. Find the value of P necessary for equilibrium. Determine the total elongation of the bar. Next thing, we have to calculate the elongation of the bar. And after that, what will be the axial load which will produce the same strain? Strain means change in length by original length, which will produce the same strain of the bar replaced by a bar of uniform cross-section area. Here the bar is having a cross-section. First one is 400 millimeter square, second one 800 millimeter square, and third one 600 millimeter square. So we are replacing the bar with a bar of uniform cross section having the same length. The length remains same, having a diameter of 20 mm. So first we will calculate the total elongation of the bar, and then we will replacing the bar with another bar with the 20 mm diameter having the same length. Then we have to calculate the what force required to produce the same elongation. Okay, first we will do the total elongation of the bar. So for that we will be dividing the bars into three section, and we will be calculating the total force. And before that, we should check whether the system is in equilibrium. Here the force P is not given, so we are assuming the system is in equilibrium, and we will be finding out the value of P. So towards left we got a 60 kN and a 120 kN. Total 180 kN force is acting towards left, and towards right we got a 96 kN and a P. So 60 plus 120 should be equal to 96 plus. So we'll calculate the value of P as 84 kN. The value of G is given as 200 GPa, and 1 Pascal equal to 1 Newton per meter square, and 1 MPa equal to 1 Newton per mm square. So 200 GPa can be written as 200 × 10⁹ Pascal. Giga means 10⁹. So 10⁹ can be written as again 10�³ × 10⁶. For 10⁵ is called mega. So we can write 200 × 10�³ MPa as this E. Similarly, 1 MPa equal to 1 Newton per mm square. So we can write 200 × 10�³ Newton per mm square is the value of E. Or they have written as 2 × 10⁵ Newton per mm square as the value of G. Okay. So first we'll apply the method of superposition for finding out the total force acting on the each bar. Okay. First thing, first bar having a 60 newton towards the left, so it should have a 60 newton towards the right. In this figure, we don't have any 60 newton force, so we'll be introducing a 60 kN force here. And we cannot simply add a force, we have to add force in the opposite direction also. Okay, so in total, we got a 60 plus 60, so both got cancelled. The first 60 kN is used here, so we'll be cancelling this. Okay. Second 60 kN remains here, and the net force acting on section B, 60 towards left and a P. The value of P we have already calculated, it is 84. Value of P is equal to 84. So 60 kN towards left and a 84 kN towards right. So net effect, we got a 24 kN towards right. Okay. So for section B to C, we got a 24 kN compressive force. So obviously, at the other end also, we got a 24 kN compressive force. So, in this section, we don't have a 24 kN compressive force. So, we'll be introducing a 24 kN force here. And similarly, we are introducing a same 24 kN force in the opposite direction. And we got this 24 kN force is used here. So, it got cancelled, remaining only 24 kN. So, already it got a 120 kN force in the left direction. We are introducing another 24 kilonewton in the left direction. Actually, I have made a mistake. Okay, this 24 kilonewton is producing towards the right direction. Actually, we have introduced a 24 kilonewton towards the left direction. So this is not got cancelled. Actually, this force is got cancelled and this will remains. Okay, so when we analyze the section on this section, section C, we got a 120 kilonewton towards left and a 24 kilonewton towards right. So net effect 120 minus 24, 96 kilonewton towards left will be the force acting on section C. So if it is 96 kilonewton, obviously equal and opposite force should be there in the right end. So we got a 96 at the right end. Check whether the whether it meet with the end condition of our bar. Yes, it meet with the end condition of our bar, 96 kilonewton. So it got satisfied. So our resolution of forces is over. Now we are going to calculate the equation using the equation PL by A. Delta L is equal to PL by A, where P is the applied load, L is the length of the bar, A is the area cross section, E is the Young's modulus. Okay. For the first bar, P is equal to 60 kilonewton. For second bar, P is equal to 24 kilonewton. For the third bar, P is equal to 96 kilonewton. Okay, and the length of the bar 1 meter, 1.5 meter, and 0.5 meter. Area of cross section they have given as 40 millimeter square, 800 millimeter square, 600 millimeter square. Okay, Young's modulus we have already right in the previous slide is 2 × 10⁵ newton per millimeter square. So we'll be calculating the strain in the first one. Actually, the first bar is a tensile load, so we'll be taking it as positive. Second one is a compressive load, we'll be taking it as negative. Third one is a tensile load, will be taking it as positive. So plus 0.75, PL by A, V is equal to 60, L is equal to 1 meter. We will be converting it into millimeter, and area of cross section 400, and Young's modulus 2 × 10⁵. Okay, we got a 75 mm, and we will be taking its value as positive. And for second case, it will be is equal to 24 kilonewton, and the length is 1.5 meter, 1500, and area of cross section 800. And E remains same, 2 × 10⁵. As it is a compressive load, will be giving a negative sign. Okay. And for the third section, load applied is 96, and length is 0.5 meter, that is 500 millimeter. Area of cross section 600, and Young's modulus 2 × 10⁵, 0.4 mm. As it is a tensile load, will be taking it as a positive. So net effect plus 75 minus 225 plus 0.4 is equal to 0.925 millimeter is the total elongation of the bar. So it is our first part of the question. In the second part, we are asked to find out, we'll be replacing the bar with a single bar. We'll be replacing the bar with a single bar having diameter 20 mm, which produce the same strain. So strain means change in length by original length. So original length, so we'll be replacing the bar with a uniform cross section with the same length. So we got the same length. Length means 1 plus 1.5 plus 0.5. So total 3 meter will be the length of the bar. And the change in length we have already calculated. It's equal to 0.925. So 0.925 divided by 4 meters. 4000 will be the strain. So it will produce the same strain. This is the total strain. 0.25 divided by 4000 total strain. It will produce the same strain. So strain remains the same. So strain is equal to delta L by L. Okay. Actually I have made a mistake. The total length is 1.5 plus 0.5, 2 plus 1, 3. Actually, it is 3 meter. I have by mistake told it is a 4 meter. Okay. So strain is equal to delta L by L. So we got a length of the mean as 300 mm, and strain is given 0.5. Delta L by L is equal to 0.14. Okay. So we substitute the value of strain here, and we can write stress by strain is equal to Young's modulus, which is equal to PL by A. Delta L is equal to PL by A, and we have to find out the value of P. L is given as 3 meter. Area of cross section, they have mentioned that we are replacing with a bar of 20 mm cross section. So we'll be calculating the value of diameter using the equation pi by 4 d square, or they have used the pi r square. For the same, pi by 4 d square and pi r square is the area of a circle. So both are same. So we'll be calculating the area of cross section 0.314 millimeter square. So and Young's modulus remains the same. So we'll be calculating the value of P as 87.92 kilonewton. Okay. So it is a little bit advanced question from the elongation of bar. So we'll do one more question. It's the last question from the elongation of the bar. A tensile load of 60 kilonewton is acting on a rod of diameter 40 mm. So it's a rod having diameter 40 mm and length 4 meter. The bore diameter is 20 mm. So bore means it got a hole. So boring is the operation by which producing a hole on a solid material. Either it will be a shaft or circular cylinder. Cylinder means it's a hollow. Okay. A circular shaft will be producing a cylindrical hole that is called a boring. So a bore can of diameter means hole of diameter 20 mm is made centrally on a rod. What length the rod should be bored? So they haven't specified the length of the hole. Okay. To what length the rod should be bored so that the total elongation should increase by 20% under the same tensile load. So they have mentioned that the bar already got an elongation that we have to calculate. Actually, the bar don't have the hole. Actually, the bar is don't have the hole. The bar is having a diameter 40 mm and a length 4 meter, and it got a force of 60 kilonewton. So we'll be calculating the equation, calculating the elongation by using the equation PL by A. So we'll be PL by A. We'll be calculating the equation elongation, and after that they are telling that they are drilling a hole. Anyway, if material is removed from a specimen, obviously its strength will be reduced. So for the same load, it will elongate more. So to what length they have to drill the hole so that the elongation should increase by 20%? So first we will calculate the elongation, and we will calculate the 20% extra elongation, and we will calculate the length of the hole. So first we will calculate the elongation considering this as a solid bar. Then we are calculating the what will be the 20% extra elongation. And we will be analyzing the elongation, that is the total elongation of the bar. And we will be giving the value of the hole as x, and we will be finding out the value. So we will be dividing this as two sections. One section having a solid cylinder, another section having a hollow cylinder. We will be adding the elongation of first section and the second section. So first thing we have to do, the find the elongation of the bar considering this bar as a solid bar. So we will be considering it as a solid bar using the equation PL by AE. We will be calculating the equation P is equal to 60 kilonewton, 16:10⁻³. L is the length of the bar, 4 meter. Area of cross section is given 40 mm, so pi by 4 d square, so 400 pi. And actually this is wrong, they have given us 40 mm. So we will be calculating the elongation 0.9554. Okay, so we got an elongation of 0.9554. Now they have given we have to increase the elongation by 20%. So we'll be increasing the elongation by 20%. So we'll be multiplying with 120 divided by 100, or we'll be multiplying with 1.2. 20% extra means we'll be it will be multiplied with 120 by 100. If you want to calculating 50% of a value, we will be multiplying with 50 by 100. If you want to calculate the 75% of a value, we will be multiplying with 75 by 100. If you want to calculate 120% of a value, we will be multiplying with 120 by 100. So we got the total elongation. This is a new elongation, 120 by 100 into 0.995. Now we got a bore of x mm. So we got a two section with the hollow cylinder and a solid cylinder. The length of the hollow cylinder is x, and the length of the solid cylinder is 4000 minus x. Okay, so we'll be calculating the elongation of the unbored bar or solid portion. That's equal to PL by A. We are having the same load. So 60 divided by A, this is sigma 47.77, that we have PL P divided by A here, and into L. L is 4000 minus x. This is the length of the solid portion. Actually, up total length is 4000. Up to this, we got a hollow cylinder having a distance x. So remaining portion will be 4000 minus x. So length is equal to 4000 minus x, and Young's modulus 2 into 10 raised to 5. This is the elongation of the solid portion. Now we will be calculating the stress in the bored portion. Again, stress equal to load by area. Load by area is equal to load divided by outer dia minus inner dia. So pi by 4 d square, capital D square, that will be 40 mm, and we are having a bore of diameter 20 mm. Small d is equal to 20 mm. So pi by 4 into 40 square minus 20 square. So we got this is the stress. That is equal to 63.69 Newton per mm square. Now we are going to calculate the elongation. So elongation is given by PL by AE. P by A is, we already got the value 63.69. We will be using that value into L. L is the length of the board section, that is equal to X. And A we have already used, we will be dividing with the E. So this is the elongation of the bored portion. So this is the elongation of the unbored portion. This is the elongation of the bored portion. We should have the total elongation should be like this, 120% of the initial elongation. So we'll be equating with the sum of elongation of the bored portion and the sum of the elongation of the unbored portion with the total elongation. So we got, we'll be adding these two as the denominator remains same, and we will be finding out the value of x as 2400 millimeter up to a distance of 2400 mm, that is 2.4 meter we have to drill a hole to make the elongation 20% more. So that is this is a maximum level of question that you can expect from a bar subject to uniform or a tapering bar subject to, or from the method of superposition. Okay, so that's all for today. We'll be discussing a new topic, uniformly tapering bar, we'll be discussing in the next class. Thank you.